Learning new software? Get ready for a revolution. This changes everything you thought you knew about tutorials. Learning new software can be a nightmare. You're stuck with outdated tutorials, confusing instructions, and no one to answer your questions. But what if there was a better way? Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. I'm kind of putting myself out of a job here today on YouTube for what I'm showing you. For the last 9 years, I've created how-to tutorials on software, but I'm going to show you how AI will probably take this over, and I'll have to be ready to pivot to something else on YouTube if I'm going to stay on it, because AI will be able to teach you any software you want on your computer, and it will expand from there. So I'm going to be showing you how to use Google AI Studio. This is completely for free and you can log in and get access to this, and I'll show you that. And then I'm going to show you how it can teach you something. And I'm going to use Microsoft Excel as an example of how to teach me how to use pivot tables. We're going to be using Google AI Studio here today. I'll put the link down below in the description so you can click on it, come to here, completely free the way I'm using it. You just have to accept the terms. When you get to this, we're going to be looking at the stream real time. I have a different video where I talk about the create the prompt if you want to check that out too. But I'm going to go to stream real time, and we're going to be taking a look at the share your screen option so I can see everything on your screen. And I'll just take a quick look at show Gemini to show how it can see you as well. Let's get started. I have Microsoft Excel open here, and I just have some random data of these ice cream sales here. I'm going to have a conversation with Gemini to walk me through how to create a pivot table. So this is something I've created videos on before, but is this something that you could see that if you had this ability, you wouldn't go to a YouTube channel to try to do it? You just would have the conversation with your AI on the computer. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to click on this screen here. I'm already logged into the Google AI Studio. You can see I'm under Flash 2 Experimental, Gemini 2.0. You need to be in the multimodal, and the output is going to be audio. And you can change the different voices here. I'm just going to leave it with this one here, and I'm not going to change anything else. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen here. So as soon as I do this, and it's already hearing me. You can hear me, right? Can you see, what do you see right now?
Yes, I can hear you. I am currently seeing a blank screen.
Oh, that's because I haven't shared it yet. I'm going to share this window right here. What do you see now?
I now see an Excel spreadsheet titled Ice Cream Sales, XLSX.
Okay.
It appears to contain data.
Yeah, okay. That is what it is. So let's say my boss gave me this and he wants me to create this pivot table. I have no idea how to create pivot tables and I need some help from you. Can you explain me how to do this step by step? And don't go too fast, please. And keep it simple so I can understand.
Okay, I understand. You'd like help creating a pivot table with this data, step by step, and keeping it simple. Let's start with the basics. First, click anywhere within your data table.
Right here? Is that good?
Yes, that works perfectly. Now go to the Insert tab on the ribbon at the top of the Excel window.
Okay, I found Insert, I clicked it.
Great. Now in the top left corner of the ribbon, you should see a pivot table button.
Yes, I see
it. It should have a little table icon next to it.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and click that pivot table button.
Oh, yeah, I see it. Something happened.
Okay, a window should have popped up. It's titled Create Pivot Table. Can you see that window?
Yeah, I have the pivot table. It says pivot tape from range table or range.
That's correct. It should show your data range in the table/range box. Now below, you'll see two radio buttons. One says new worksheet and the other says existing worksheet. For this example, let's select new worksheet.
Okay, that's selected.
Excellent. Now click OK at the bottom of the Create Pivot Table window.
Okay, I hit OK. I don't see anything. I just see this pivot table 4 thing over here.
Okay. You should also see a pivot table fields pane on the right side of your screen. Can you confirm that you can see that pane with the list of fields?
Yes, I see that.
Okay, perfect. Now to build a basic pivot table, let's start by clicking the checkbox next to region in that pivot table fields pane.
Oh, I checked it, yep.
Great. You should now see the different regions listed in the rows of the pivot table. Now let's also click the checkbox next to total sales to see the sum of sales for each region.
Okay, I clicked that.
Now you have a basic pivot table showing the total sales for each region. Is this what you were looking for?
Yeah, what do I do with these other, I have columns and filters. What do I do there?
Great question. You can use the columns and filters areas to further organize and analyze your data. For example, if you drag the flavor field to the columns area, your pivot table would show a column for each flavor, breaking down the sales in each region by flavor.
Oh,
yeah. Do you want to try that, or do you?
I did try that. That I see what happened there. You know, my boss did want to know kind of by each salesperson to know, you know, to be able to look. How could I do that?
Okay, to see sales by salesperson, you can drag the salesperson field from the pivot table fields list to the rows area and place it above the region field. This will nest salespersons within each region.
Okay, I see. What do I do with filters?
Great, you should. To use filters, you can drag a field like flavor to the filters area. Then, above your pivot table, you'll see a dropdown where you can select specific flavors to include in your report.
Okay, this drop down over here.
Exactly. You can use that drop down to filter the data in the pivot table based on the flavor selected. Does this make sense?
Yes. Okay, I think my boss might like that. Well, thank you for your help. Do you think, here's a non-Excel question, do you think as this progresses, this type of technology, do you see with the glasses that are going to come out with what Google creates, will you just be able to look at anything and be able to offer this type of help?
That's an interesting question about future technology. As a language model, I don't have the ability to see or interact with the world like a person wearing smart glasses. However, it's certainly possible that future iterations of technology could allow me to assist users with real-time data analysis by seeing what they see.
All right, I'm going to stop sharing now. And I just wanted to show everybody here that everything is recorded in the stream real time, but it doesn't get saved here yet. So everything, you can download these different conversations, and there's different playback speeds if you want to review any of this. So that's just an example of Gemini reading my computer screen, but it can do more than that. As this advances, let me give you a demo of this right here, Show Gemini. So even if I was writing something down on a piece of paper, it will be able to see it. When I go ahead and click Show Gemini, you can see there I am. Gemini sees me. Okay, you see me, right?
Okay. I see the man in the video. He's looking directly at the camera.
What am I wearing?
You are wearing a dark gray collared shirt. Is there anything else you would like to know?
Yeah, what am I holding up right now?
You are holding up a white piece of paper that has 5 × 3 = 12 written on it.
Is this correct?
Would you like to ask me? No, that is not correct. 5 × 3 = 15, not 12. Would you like me to help you with more math?
No, I just want to explain people all the different capabilities that you have. So not only when I shared my screen did it help me, I could be writing paper down on paper, and if the camera's seeing me, it will be able to help me right there. Going back to what I mentioned about the glasses before, when the glasses come out, it will be able to help you in many different situations. So what do you think about this? Is this the end of how-to videos on YouTube? Should I start looking for a different type of YouTube channel? Is this something, a way that you would like to learn? I see as this progresses, I would probably learn like this if I can get instant feedback looking at the data that I have on my screen, if it can walk me through like this. And it's going to only get better. So I would also think AI agents would help fill in the information. If I wanted data in the Excel spreadsheet, it will manipulate things like that. Lots of things are going to happen. I'd really like to know your thoughts on it down below in the comments. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.